The cairn on which the trig pillar sits had started to get seriously undermined. So some refurbishment work took place and we wanted to be involved with that. And we just thought it was a good idea, an opportune moment to go check the height of the highest point in the country.
We took up with us a GNSS receiver, tripod, a laptop to control it, levelling stave and level, plus personal equipment, food, water, rainwear, walking boots, everything you need for a day's trip to the mountains. By the time we reached the cloud level, which I suppose was about 1,000 metres, things were worsening slightly, and by the time we got to the top, it was a proper whiteout, full rain, sleet, snow just to help us along, and bitterly cold and blowing probably 40 or 50 miles an hour. This equipment will work in any weather, and so will the Toughbook, unfortunately, so it's just us that suffers. The equipment is capable of doing anything that we ask of it.
As part of the checks, once the cairn was finished, to make sure the trig pillar hadn't been disturbed too much and it hadn't moved too much, we decided to go up there and see what the height was. I saw a height that rounded us to 1345. It's quite surprising. You initially think, my God, we've just raised the height of the highest mountain in the country by a metre on the face of our maps. So it's a little bit more significant than some of the other computations we tend to do every day. But it's quite interesting when it happens.
Do you take a deep breath and start looking at the calculations?
Well, yeah, of course. You double check everything just to make sure that you absolutely have got this one 100% right. And we have, and we are sure that this is the best answer that's going to come out of this.